fingers crossed, he says. We're almost set to go. Let's bring it on in the Stella Artois Auckland Cup of 2012. They are away and racing at long last. She's sensational. Sparrow on the inside, giving plenty. She's sensational, and Sparrow, as they go to the post. Five links, she's sensational, has done it. She is simply stunning.
The Group 1 Barfoot and Thompson Auckland Cup is New Zealand's premier staying event, contested over 2 miles with runners vying for $500,000. The time-honoured Auckland Cup features winners which include the names of Castletown, Miltac, Jezebel, Prize Lady and She's Sensational. This year's field is headed by former VRC Derby winner Sangster, who has returned to form this season with wins in the Group 1 Darcy Brahma International Stakes and the Group 2 Avondale Cup. The busted and young trained galloper will start the short price favourite with the TAB bookmakers in this year's race.
But Sangster under 59, how can they ever beat him in the Cup in a few weeks' time? Sangster, hugely impressive.
From the get-go, we've been happy with this, the way he's progressed his campaign, so The winning this time is no surprise because he's been spot on all the way through. It's nice to have a dominant horse going into a Group 1 race. Very exciting for the stables. Everything's gone nicely and I certainly wouldn't want to swap him for any other horse in the race.
Former New Zealand Cup winner My Scots Grey returns to top-level competition after spending time on the sideline through injury. The son of Goldland is a proven two-miler who will make his presence felt.
Still there, My Scots Grey's gone to the lead from Zarbina. The stablemates try and chase, smoking chimneys and halls. It's the Cambridge Galloper though, My Scots Grey. The Grey's going to win the Cup, My Scots Grey by a length on Zarbina.
You know, he's a terrific stayer. The question is, will it be long enough? You know, he really is the sort of horse who the further he goes, the better he gets. And as we all know, there's fewer and fewer two-mile races nowadays. So this is the race we've sort of set him for all the way through. And let's just hope some of them don't run the trip out, as we already know he can. You know, confident in our jockey, we're sure the horse will run well for us.
Waikato Cup winner Annie Higgins, the highest rated mare in the field, will be looking for Group 1 glory in this year's Auckland Cup as she takes on the 3200 metres for the first time.
Annie Higgins made the lead in the Cup now from Better Together. Arconciel, Dolma Bache arriving on the inside. Annie Higgins and Better Together set down to fight it out. Line third, Arconciel, Annie's in front, and Annie Higgins won the Cup.
Her form over ground is outstanding. She's riding in a nice weight. I don't think the 2 miles will be a problem to her. I think everyone wants a genuine speed in it, but if it is a slowly run race, it all depends where you're positioned, and she can take a spot in a race, so that's a help. I'm really happy. I think her form suggests she should be thereabouts. Obviously, Sangster's coming into it and at the right time and looks an outstanding prospect, but I'm looking forward to the competition.
The Raymond Connors-trained Blood Brother also takes his place in the field after a superb win in this year's Wellington Cup. Chaperone joins the mix after some eye-catching runs during her build-up for trainer Stephen McKee. The runners will contest the Group 1 2013 Barfoot and Thompson Auckland Cup at Ellerslie on Wednesday, the 6th of March.